Hi Berit.
Hi Rom.
We just got a project from a customer and we installed the PXC controller in the building to reduce its energy consumption. Now we're looking to integrate this Modbus duct sensor as it will allow us to use much less wiring and save project costs. I've heard that integrating a Modbus device in ABT Site is straightforward. Can you show me how it works?
Sure Rom. Engineering of Modbus devices is really easy. Let me show you. I have in the tool already the Modbus editor open. We see that we have our air handling unit, which is running on this PXC4. The Modbus network, but we do not have any Modbus devices yet. So we go to the library, which we see on the right-hand side, where we have a huge list of pre-engineered Modbus devices. The filter bar will help us to narrow down the list to what we are looking for. We need a sensor, we type in sensor and see the reduced list. In this case, if we know already that this one is the QFM, we can already directly filter for the QFM. And we see the list, the upper one is the one that we do need. All we have to do is we drag and drop the device to our network. As having the device added, we see in the table below that for all important data points of this device, we already have standard magnet objects available. And now, to go online, all we have to do, we have to align the baud rate of this device, check in the properties, I adjust the baud rate, and like this, we are ready to test it. And for this, we go to the play mode. The tool does a little check, delta compile, and a delta load. And now we see the orange frame appearing, means we are in the live mode now. And you can see in the table below, right now, we have 23 degrees Celsius in our room.
It's nice that we could integrate the data points of this Modbus sensor in a few clicks and being able to see the live value provided by the device right after we add it to our engineering plan also helps a lot. But now, can I still modify it from the library or even create my own device? And can I save it and share it for a later use?
Sure. So in case you do not want to use all the data points that come with the backnet with the Modbus device that you take out of library, you can simply select the objects, let's say humidity we are not interested in, and right click to delete them. In case the Modbus device would support further data point, you can of course also add them. I show you this by even showing you how easy it is to add your own device in case you do not find it in the library. For that, you click on the Modbus network and choose Add Device. Give it a name, for example an actuator, and press OK. Now you add the data points to it. Simply by clicking Add Data Point, you see a list. Choose what kind of backnet object type you want to have. Choose any of them, analog input, can give it a proper name, choose according to the data sheet of this Modbus device the according settings, out of the data sheet, enter them, and like this, you are done. You have engineered your Modbus device with its data point. And if you want to reuse it, that's very easy. All you have to do, you take the modified or the newly created device, and simply drag and drop it to the custom library. And like this, you can use this device next time, same as we did with the QFM previously.
Having the possibility to reuse the work of others with a simple file upload is a really nice feature to avoid extra efforts. Thank you for showing us how we can save tremendous time, Berit.
You're welcome.
If you would like to learn more tips on how to engineer building automation system in an easier way, check out the other ABT Site how-to videos. Thank you.